Hello dear students, how are you? Welcome back to Karim's Biology and we have been discussing the lesson Our Food. Today's session is session 6 in which we are going to talk about food preservation and we are going to learn different methods of food preservation. Okay students, let us enter into the topic.
Subscribe now and press the bell icon. Never miss an update.
But children, before I begin, I would like to ask you a few simple questions. The first question is, how do farmers protect the rice from pests and store it after it is harvested? And second one, how is rice stored in your home? Have you ever observed how your parents store the rice at your home? And why does curry get spoiled when kept out for a couple of days but pickles stays fresh for so long? How is it possible? Don't worry, you will be able to answer all these questions by the end of this session. So let us start our discussion. First, let us know, why should we preserve the food? Students, food is the energy source for us and it is rich in nutrients. And that's the reason why we consume food. Our body requires nutrients. And what is the source of nutrients to our body? It is through the food that you eat. That is why we are easily get attracted towards food whenever we look at tasty and nutritious food. But not only us children, like we get attracted to food, microorganisms like bacteria and fungi are also get attracted to nutritious food and start growing on the food material. Because you know children, like human beings, microorganisms also need to survive. And how do they survive? They survive because of the nutrients that they get out of the food. As we are getting the nutrients from the food that we eat, microbes also get their nutrients from the food. What is the source of nutrients to microbes? The same food that you are consuming is also the source of nutrients to the microorganisms. That's the reason why not only ourselves, even the microorganisms will be consuming the nutrients present in the food that you eat. But do you know children, when the microorganisms grow on food, they simply do not consume the nutrients like we do. When they grow on them, they release some chemicals onto the surface of food. And because of that, the food will be decomposed. It turns into liquid. The solid food turns into liquid because of this microbial activity. And then that liquid nutrients will be absorbed by these microorganisms. And that's the reason why they are called saprophytic organisms. And what happens then? You see the condition of the food material here. These are the fresh tomatoes that are spoiled by the growth of fungus. These are the grapes spoiled by the growth of fungus. And there is an apple which is rotten by the growth of microorganisms. Okay, so this is what microbes do to the food when they grow on them. And when this happens, we can no longer consume the food that is spoiled by microorganisms. Food is contaminated by microbes. Then what is contamination? Contamination is nothing but growth of microorganisms. When microorganisms grow, especially harmful microorganisms, when they grow on the food material, then that is called food contamination. And do you know, the bread that is left unused under moist conditions is attacked by fungus? Children, have you ever observed at your home that when you open a bread packet and if you don't properly close it and if you keep it like that, within a few days you would have observed the growth of fungus like this on that bread? Because the bread is rich in nutrients. So the fungus such as bread mold will immediately start growing on this bread and it will spoil the bread. This bread is now contaminated and microorganisms spoil our food. When they spoil the food, that particular food item emits a bad smell and it has a bad taste and color will be changed. So this is what happened to this bread here. After the growth of this bread mold, you see how the color of the bread changed and how the entire bread is spoiled. And look at this apple here again. Look at these food items. What happened to them? Their color is changed. And of course, they may be emitting very foul and bad smell, which you cannot bear. And under these conditions, can you eat this type of food? No. We cannot consume this type of food that is spoiled by microorganisms. Because there is a reason why we don't consume this contaminated food material. The reason is food poisoning. Then what is food poisoning? Children, there are some microorganisms such as Salmonella and some other bacteria such as E. coli, they are responsible majorly for spoiling food material. And do you know how do they spoil the food? When they grow on the food, they release some toxic chemicals onto the surface of the food. What does it mean by toxic chemical? A toxic chemical is a poisonous substance that is released by these microbes onto the food. This is the picture of the Salmonella bacteria, which will spoil the food. And this bacteria in particular release some toxic chemicals onto the surface of the food. And what happens? Eating the microbial contaminated food may lead to vomiting. This is what happens to most of the people. Students, you must remember that in most of the cases, the contamination of food with bacteria cannot be easily noticed. That's why most of the people, without noticing the growth of bacteria, they consume the food, because the food appears fresh, but in fact some bacteria growing on that. In that case, what happens? When they consume the food that is contaminated with Salmonella bacteria, I told you that the bacteria has already released some toxic chemicals onto the food. And when people consume that food, along with the food, the toxic chemicals released by bacteria will enter into the digestive system. And what will be your body's reaction immediately? Vomiting. So this is what happens when we consume that food that is contaminated with bacteria, contaminated with toxic chemicals. Okay, and you know, children, not only vomitings, if the dosage of the toxic chemicals that you get into your body exceeds the limit, then it may even lead to the death of the person who consumes that. Okay, so in this case, what is happening? When you consume that contaminated food material, that food itself is acting as poison, because that consists of toxic chemicals released by microorganisms. That's the reason why this is called food poisoning. It doesn't mean that you are eating poison directly. It means that you are eating food that is contaminated with toxic chemicals or poisonous chemicals. Okay, that's about food poisoning. And if the food is not prevented from spoiling, we cannot store it for a long time. Students, we have to understand the fact that we do not consume entire food at a time. Okay, the food material or vegetables that you bring from the market to your home, they have to be at least stored for 1 week, right? Because immediately you cannot cook all vegetables and you cannot consume that vegetables throughout the week. Because after some time, within 1 or 2 days, the curry that your mom cooks will be spoiled. It will stay fresh only for a few days, 1 or 2 days, but afterwards it will be spoiled by microorganisms. That's why it is inevitable for us to store the food material. But if the food is contaminated like this with microorganisms, can you store it for a long time? No, we cannot store it for a long time. That is the reason why we have to develop and follow certain methods to preserve the food for as long as possible. But don't think that all food items can be preserved for years together. There are some food items which can be preserved for 1 week, and some food items can be preserved for a few months, and some food items can be preserved for even years. Now, let us find out what is food preservation. Food preservation is a technique to prevent food spoilage, food poisoning, and microbial contamination in food. Students, just now I told you that the reason behind food spoiling and food poisoning are the microorganisms. If you want to preserve the food for a long time, you have to make sure that the food is not exposed to microorganisms. If you are able to do that, then food will be stored for a long time, because the only reason for the spoiling of food are microbes such as bacteria and fungus. And if you make sure that these bacteria and fungus do not grow on the food, then the food can be preserved for a long time. That's the principle behind food preservation. I told you, no, the most important thing in food preservation is to make sure that the growth of microbes must be prevented. When you do this, the food can be stored for a long time. Okay, then what are the objectives of food preservation? The objectives are to prevent microbial contamination. When you are preserving the food, your major goal, objective in preservation of food, is to prevent microbial contamination, isn't it? That is the first objective. And the second objective is to kill pathogens. Dear students, it is not that you can always prevent the microbial contamination. Before you start preserving the food material, already some pathogens may be present on the food material. That's why you should also make sure that if at all any pathogens are present in the food, they must be removed from the food or they must be killed, right? And the last one is to minimize food spoilage and food poisoning. So when you are able to do the first two things, then food spoilage will be minimized and food poisoning can be minimized. I hope that you understood. Thank you very much. I will meet you in my next session.